Merry Christmas, and welcome to the 2023 Knights of Columbus Carol Festival. My name is Colin Rischko, and I'm the Knights of Columbus Carol Festival chairperson. The Knights of Columbus are again very happy and proud to sponsor this year's event. We are happy to join you on Treaty 6 territory and the homeland of the Métis. Gathering together to celebrate the reason for the season, the birth of Jesus Christ on Christmas Day. Celebrating Christmas each year allows us all the opportunity to welcome Jesus into our personal lives and hearts. What better way to enjoy and to get into the Spirit than to listen to the gift of the voice, singing glory and praise to Jesus Christ, our personal Lord and Savior. As we gather to listen to and enjoy some 700 voices of our students, let's all reflect on the joy and happiness of celebrating Christ's birth. We'd like to thank the students and the teachers, the parents and the caregivers, and all of those who helped to provide their time, effort, support, and commitment to ensure that this event became a reality. I'd like to thank Darcy Leach and the Greater Saskatoon Catholic Schools for helping to make this opportunity available. And of course, we'd like to thank all of those behind the scenes and the production team to make this opportunity to share the gift of song. So on behalf of the Knights of Columbus, we wish you all a very happy and healthy Christmas season and a prosperous new year. Merry Christmas and enjoy.
Well, Slava Iisusa Christu, glory be to Jesus Christ and the Creator. My name is Diane Boyko, and I'm so happy to join you here on Treaty 6 territory in the homeland of the Métis to bring you greetings on behalf of Greater Saskatoon Catholic Schools Board of Education. For over 60 years, the Knights of Columbus have blessed the students of GSCS with the opportunity during their Advent and Pilipilka journey to raise their voices in song and adoration towards their journey to the manger in Bethlehem. Thank you so much to the Knights for their kindness, their generosity, and their commitment. Thank you to all the parents and guardians who do such a wonderful job supporting their children. Thank you so much to all our teachers and staff for the wonderful job they do readying our students. And most importantly, thank you to all the students who put us in the beautiful Christmas spirit with all of their song. So on behalf of all of us at GSCS, Merry Christmas.
George Vanier Catholic Fine Arts School is named in honor of Canada's first Catholic Governor General, a man of deep faith. George Vanier's legacy inspires students to channel their creativity towards a greater purpose, proclaiming the good news of Jesus Christ to the world. Exemplifying the profound connection between faith and artistic celebration, the students from the school named in his honor share a poignant reminder that even in the grandeur of Christmas, beauty lies in the simplicity of the gift of one small child.
Thank you.
When it first opened in 1952, St. Francis School consisted of only 74 students. In 2007, through a partnership with the Saskatoon Tribal Council, a citywide Cree language program was established. And today, St. Francis Cree Bilingual School is now home to over 600 students. Incorporating Indigenous knowledge and heritage programming, St. Francis is an award-winning center for Cree culture and language revitalization, and the largest Indigenous language school in Canada. In the spirit of truth and reconciliation, we walk together with the students from St. Francis on the road to Bethlehem as we prepare our hearts for the birth of Christ, who reconciles all things to himself.
Hallelujah.
Prior to his ordination as bishop in 1967, Bishop James Mahoney was the first principal of Holy Cross High School when it opened in 1963. Known for his genuine love of people, his compassion, and his warm sense of humor, Bishop Mahoney was a beloved shepherd of the church in Saskatoon. As the students of the school named in his honor sing of the star that led the way to Bethlehem, we are reminded of the legacy of Bishop Mahoney, a gentle guiding light showing us the way to Christ. Cardinal Paul Émile Léger was born in Quebec, but his love for God and his remarkable passion took him to places as far away as France, Japan, Rome, and Africa. As he served God in those around him, his work demonstrated his commitment and his ardent desire to preach the gospel to the ends of the earth. Today, students from École Cardinal Léger School follow the example of their namesake as they too take to the mountaintops to share the good news of Christ's birth with the world.
Once upon a time,
According to tradition that dates back centuries, Christians have honored Saint Anne as the mother of Mary and the maternal grandmother of Jesus. Childless for many years, Anne remained faithful and hopeful as she fervently prayed for a child. In response to Anne's patience and goodness, God answered her prayers and blessed her with a daughter like no other, the Mother of God. Today, the students of St. Anne's School rely upon her example of patience while they too await a special gift from God. The symbol of the Holy Cross is a sign of God's love that spans millennia. When viewed in the light of the ageless prayer, O come, Emmanuel, the cross signifies the fullness of ancient prophecies. As the students from Holy Cross sing the words of the ancient prayer in a new musical setting, past and present converge, and we reflect on the enduring power of faith and its sacred echoes that resonate across the ages.
Oh.
canonized in 1982 and the first Canadian female saint. Saint Marguerite Bourgeois is known for her life of prayer and service. Recognized as a teacher who watched over her students with affection and confidence, Saint Marguerite opened the first school in Montreal in 1658 in a borrowed stable. Today, the students of the Saskatoon School named in her honor remind us of the beauty that borrowed stables can tenderly hold. Bishop Pocock School was opened in 1978, the same year that Bishop Philip Pocock, the second and youngest ever Bishop of Saskatoon, retired after a lifetime of faithful service. Bishop Pocock was well known for his warmth and his love for celebrating Masses with children. Doubtless, he would be filled with pride and great love today as the students from the school named in his honor sing of the Savior's birth with gladness and joy. St. Peter the Apostle is one of the most well-known saints in Christianity and is widely acknowledged as one of Jesus' closest friends. It was Peter who recognized Jesus as the Messiah and who spoke on behalf of the disciples when he proclaimed Jesus the Son of the Living God. Today, the Friends of Jesus from École, St. Peter School follow the example of their namesake as they sing on behalf of their companions of the baby born in Bethlehem, the Son of the Living God. In the ancient song, O Come Emmanuel, the repeated urgent plea, come, reminds us of a child's eager and impatient waiting for Christmas. This is reflected in the letter of Pope John Paul II to the children of the world in 1994. Christmas is the feast day of a child. So it is your feast day too. You wait impatiently for it and get ready for it with joy, counting the days and even the hours to the holy night of Bethlehem. May we too wait with the eagerness of a child's heart as we echo the words, O come, Emmanuel.
This is how the birth of Jesus came about. There was a census taking of the entire Roman world, and everyone went to his own city to register. So Joseph went up to Bethlehem, the city of David. He went there with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child.
While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in clothes and placed him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn.
There were shepherds out in the fields nearby, keeping a watch over their flocks by night. Suddenly, an angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were afraid.
The angel said, I bring you good news of great joy that will be for all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. And this will be a sign unto you. You will find the baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger. Suddenly, a great company of heavenly hosts appeared, praising God and saying, Glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace, goodwill to men.
Thank you.
Only two Gospels tell the story of the Nativity, and it is only in the Gospel of Luke that we hear the angel Gabriel visiting Mary. Foretelling the birth of Jesus, the angel speaks to her of a child who will be given the throne of his ancestor, David, and whose kingdom will have no end. As the students from St. Luke's School sing of the baby king that she holds in her arms, we hear echoes of Mary's wonder and reverence as she recalls the angel's message and contemplates all that the future holds. St. Joseph High School is named in honor of the earthly father of Jesus, who comes to our attention during the Advent and Christmas seasons. Because Joseph was a descendant of King David, he and Mary were required to return to David's birthplace for the census ordered by the emperor. And it was there in the city of David, Bethlehem, that Jesus was born. Today, the students of St. Joseph High School sing joyfully of their mission to send everyone to see that baby boy born in Bethlehem, Joseph's ancestral home.
Children, go, go, where I send thee? Children, how shall I send thee?
St. George School is named for the Christian martyr who has been honored for centuries for his courage, faith, and selflessness. When the school opened its doors in 1979, it also paid homage to George Molloy, the first and only full-time secretary treasurer in the history of Greater Saskatoon Catholic Schools, who retired that same year. Today, the legacy of faith left to us by both men lives on in the witness of the students of St. George School as they sing with joy to the little King who comes to us at Christmas.